Hello everyone, welcome to Feel Free to Code. My name is Viren and now we will start our new project. Okay, so open IntelliJ IDEA and click on create a new project and then select Java and select the Java SDK. So I have two Java SDK installed, so I am selecting Java 14. Okay, so we installed 14 JDK 14 in the last video, so I selected 14, then click on next and then create a project from template. Okay, then click on next. Then project name, so type a project name here. I am typing here swing underscore demo. Okay, then click on save. Then this is our project. So this is our root directory, swing demo. Okay, here is a folder src, so all the code we will put here. So there is a folder that is package com.feelfreetocode. Okay, so there is a folder and inside the com folder there is another folder feelfreetocode. Okay, so this is called package in Java. So I am now working on com.feelfreetocode. This is our package and here a main class, that is our start class. Okay, so our application will start from here. Okay, so let's create a main frame here. So click on src, click on your package name and then click on new and then click on swing UI designer and GUI form. Okay, so we have to create a GUI form here. So type form name. Form name means you can type your window name. So I am typing here my frame or main frame. Okay, so this is my main frame. Then click on okay. So there is a class name bounded to this frame, main frame. So automatically IntelliJ IDEA will create a class main frame dot java. Okay, so this is main frame dot form where we will design your frame. Okay, we will design our frame here. So this is general frame. Okay, so click on frame, right click on frame, then go click on jump to source. So this is our jump, this is our code where we will we will write our logic code for the controller. Okay, and the main frame dot form represent the GUI of the application. So let's create an object of main frame, or J frame. So we will show this frame. Okay, we want to open this frame in our application. So let's see how you can open. So I am closing it. Then go to main frame. Okay, so here nothing. Okay, nothing is here. So click on project, open main frame dot form. So you have to set the field name. Okay, for this J panel. So I am typing here. I will name this J panel as a main panel. Okay, so main panel and press enter, save it and then click on form jump to source. So you can see there is private member, private J panel, main panel. Okay, so it is generated automatically by IntelliJ IDEA. Okay, so it will initialize when you run your application, it will automatically initialize by the IntelliJ IDEA. Okay, by the JVM. Okay, so how it is being initialized, we will discuss in the next video. Okay, so don't miss the next video because it will help to understand the swing application when you develop from the IntelliJ IDEA, how it is generating the code, how it is initializing this main frame or all the private fields. Okay, so we will discuss in the next video. So let's create a constructor here. So main frame. Okay, just create a main frame constructor here. Press alt insert and create constructor. Okay, so this is main frame and create a getter for this main panel. Okay, because this is the main panel where we put our other components inside the main panel. So this is our main panel, so create a getter for this main panel. Okay, so get, this is a getter of main panel. Save it and back to your main.java. create a frame here. Okay, create a object of frame. So create a frame. So there is a class that is JFrame that creates a frame for our application. Okay, so create a JFrame object. Now JFrame okay, equal new JFrame. Okay, so this is our object and then frame dot set title. So this will set the title of the frame. For example, you are seeing the title of this IntelliJ IDEA, that the title is swing demo and this is a path. This is our title of the window. So set title hello world, this is title, and then frame dot set content pane. Content pane means you want to set the content of this frame. Okay, so we want the this J panel. Okay, we want this J panel. So back to your main.java and create a object of main frame. So new main frame dot get main panel. Okay, so it will return the main panel, and this will set the UI of our application in the mainframe on our JFrame. Okay, so back to your main.java and click frame.setVisible, because it will be invisible. It will be invisible initializing by default. Okay, so you have to pass the boolean value here. So I am passing it true because we want to set visible this frame as true. Okay, so this line will visible the frame. Fine. Then you have to set the size. So frame dot set size. Set size. Pass the width and height. So width I want to set 600 and comma 200. Fine. Save it. And the last step, frame dot set default close operation. Okay. So when you click on the frame's red button, this is the red button. This is the close button. When you click on it, the application will be exit. Okay. So for this reason, we are going to call the frame dot set default close operation, set it to exit on close. Okay, so exit on close, when I click on the red button, it will exit. Fine. Save it and click the main.java, run main.java. So it will run your application and it will create an object of JFrame. It will set the title of frame, then it will set the content of the JFrame, like mainframe.get main panel. So whatever we design in our main panel, it will set to this content pane. Then we set it to visible is equal to true, and we set it the size 600 multiplied by 200, and then set it the default close operation, that is Windows constant on exit on close, means when we click on this red button, application will be closed. Okay, fine. So this is our first first frame that we created using the GUI. Okay, so the next video I will show you there is another approach to create this frame again. Okay, so we will discuss about the secondary approach where we will not create this JFrame object in the main class. Okay, see you in the next video. Thanks for watching.